tractor was the first tractor that was offered on rubber tracks. Very few of these are still known in existence because of the obvious reason of the tracks wear so easily. That's why they ain't running in the grass. Here's another very rare tractor. This is owned by Rudy Speed of Wisconsin. It's a number four. With an adjustable life run owned by Harold Howell from Burner, Iowa. He's done an excellent job of restoring it. Thank you. South Dakota owns this Oliver Model 105 Burton tractor. These were made for Oliver by the Jacobson Lawnmower Company. They're pretty rare. They're awfully hard to find. Fred Kirkham, the owner of this Oliver 66 Row Crop with Bender extensions. He's got a nice little wagon back there with a good load. There's an Oliver 80 Row Crop with an the one ahead of it. It's a very rare tractor. The industrial has little changes here and there to make a difference in the standard.
Owned by Ed Lane and Bob Burgers.
74, 1365 hours. You were made by the guy, 74 hours. You know, the front wheel is hit, and one of the only things that tractors use around the bar every day. Hey, folks, I want you to take a look at this exhibit. This is a Super 77 diesel owned by Kevin Cross and the Power. There's a 1955 model.
This is like the first corn seller that Dan used to use before he died.
Northside Tractor Draw Boys Day 1914. Congratulations, Lloyd, being selected as Grade Marshal this year. Miss Perry Williams, I introduced a little earlier, is Shauna Malsa. She's a senior at the culminating of high school, and she's doing a very nice job at attending all of the various events we have here this weekend at Perry Village, and I'm sure she's going to do a good job of representing the village at all the various functions that she has to this coming year. She's at a model T board in 1924, model owned by Mrs. Mrs. Wickery. Can't read your writing.
Push button drive. How many people remember the Dodge Chrysler Corporation that push button?
video. That's got about 10,000 miles on it. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the original paint. Our never been restored, that's the original paint. Here's kind of a, what we have to say. There's a Hyundai, there's a cute little pickup. Anyway, a little 1963 Chevy Corvette pickup that never really did catch on, so it did last a long, long time. That's great. It's a good thing that people like him pick these up and keep them. He sails on Madison's on the road. Now we have David Pearson's 1920 model G4 car, and it's very well restored. We're in the restoration process, I should say, but it's does not do anything. Here's where we have a little more fun. These were the guys that got all the gals. I can tell you, they really did. Yeah, you were the guys that got all the gals. You're living proof because you had a different gal than every parade that I've seen had this year. 1932 Roadster with Whale Park. Here's a Chevrolet Standard Deluxe, 1935 model. I commented yesterday, this is Henry Kohlmeyer's Coleman, South Dakota. Henry, my wife got the whole family along today. Hi, Henry, nice to see you. I like the hubcaps on this one. This is a Henny Packard Hearse, 1953. It's owned by Ellsworth Funeral Home here in Madison, South Dakota. And it was purchased from Herb Willoughby in Howard, South Dakota, and I guess enough said.
Not ready to go yet.
That's right, not ready. I don't see any people coming around from here. This is a 1924 Model T4. It's old Christensen's. And Judy, can't forget Judy would be in trouble. And they come from Tigger, South Dakota. Christensen parking on it. See, you put Christensen parking on there, that's totally tax deductible. You deduct your hobbies. 1964, same. It was kind of a short car. You're doing a hard job. It's a Jimmy and Allen. This is Rick and Tim Barnes from Colton, South Dakota. And it's got a battle red paint, 327 with a four girl. And it's restored with a little help from some of his friends. He's president of the Paradise Jimmy Club. 1955. Owned by Pete Carlo Peterson, Todd Coleman. There's a cute little pickup. There's kind of a neat outfit. If you have any trouble during the Village Prairie days and you need a tow, all right, here's the guy that can do it. 1925 Ford TT Gardner, and it's Tom Soseland. He's really made up and has a handmade operating director. That's how you can. Hi there, how are you today? Having a good time? Good. That's a 1928 Ford Model A closed cab pickup. It's Keith Knudsen from Madison. He's certainly no Sunday driver. He's driven almost daily, and it's a regular working truck. He runs errands with it and keeps it busy. Here's another one of the big cars of the 60s, the 68 Plymouth Fury. Joyce is a Dean Michael from Madison. Boy, that's a good one in Plymouth Fury. That was back when we liked the big boats and big long night. This little one coming back with a 32 is a friend of mine from Birkings, South Dakota, Randy Lund. He's got a 1926 Ford Model T. Hi, Randy. And Randy and his wife, Sandy, have been exhibiting things here at the Prairie Village for the last 8 years. Now we get back to the trucking business. The 1919 Ford Model T, Allen Jonas Peters from Lenox, South Dakota. This is all original except the paint. The Judith said she painted it herself. You got nothing on this? Well, I don't know. I mean, if this is an Iowa invasion or what it is, but they've got an Iowa plate that says Nancy, I'm not reading off of what you got. You got it? We'll tell you all about it. It was a 1954 Dodge M37 Army truck, and it's Carl Lynn's. It's Korean War vintage. It's a roof truck. It was restored back in 93. During the last 14 years, it was used as a TR truck. Here's a car friend of mine had. 60 Chevy Impala convertible, Harold and Carol East from Valley Springs, South Dakota. I had a good friend of mine. I bought his car. And he bought one of those, and then we raced his whole car, and I was running against him. He beat me, but I don't know. that very village since then, very village was actually started this year, the headlines, the sidelines, and the resorts. That one's been every prairie village parade. This is a 1972 Buick. New, it was $4,500. Can you believe that? What would that car cost today? 1972 Buick Skylark.
Absolutely. 50 Chevy is our next one. This is Al. This is their first year, and I think they're probably in front of the small.
I like girls like you to give me their phone number.
Yeah, and I'll take this.
What else? They got a cute little display of antique, miniature antique horse riding equipment.